Believe it or not, it's not a half track, it's the wheeled version of the White M3, and they were used as a high-speed scout and reconnaissance vehicle. Now, in this particular case, that is our radio commander on board that vehicle. He's the man with the radio who's talking both to the artillery and to the air support. He's the one who's been talking to all of the aircraft and taking on board their reconnaissance report. Now you can see a squad of German infantry retreating back towards the defensive position. They want to get in those trenches as fast as they can. And rolling out behind them is a Stuck 3. That's basically a Panzer 3 chassis that's been modified as basically mobile artillery. Once it was in service, they discovered that it actually made a cracking anti-tank weapon as well. And in behind them, three SDKFZ 251s, the famous Hanamag half-track. But leading that parade is a real veteran of Normandy. That's the vehicle I was talking to you about from Steyr, the KFZ 15. It's a troop carrier. And that vehicle was actually captured in Normandy, having been damaged by shrapnel and then by machine gun fire. And you can still see the shrapnel damage on the bonnet of that vehicle and the machine gun holes in the rear. It's followed by a Zundapp motorcycle. And the artillery control has called in the first shots of a barrage. You can see the artillery on top of the hill, they're opening fire. And putting down a barrage into the field. That barrage is going to roll forward very slowly down the field to chivvy the German vehicles to keep them moving. And the Allied forces are going to advance in behind it. So the KFZ 15, three SDKFZ 251s. By one of the Opel trucks, and he's got a foot clearly. He's got four machine guns mounted on the back of that for anti-aircraft defence, and bringing up the rear, as I said, the Stuck 3. Stuck 3, as I said, intended as mobile artillery. They found they made quite a good tank killer. Look how low it is. It hasn't got a turret, but it's mounted in the hull. So it's got a very, very low profile. They built over 7,000 Stuck 3s during the Second World War, and they saw service in every single field of operations. Garrison artillery volunteers up on the hill with their 25-pounders, making a rolling barrage forward across the field. German vehicles taking position around the concrete bunker. You can see the small wheeled armoured car. That's an SDKFZ 223. That's their radio command vehicle. That's their command vehicle, and he's radioing all the troops and all the vehicles to get them to take position. Some serious firepower coming down on the field now. 25-pounder British light artillery. Just the most fantastic field gun could be brought into position, set up very, very quickly indeed. As you can see, it makes an incredible bang. So light artillery putting forward their rolling barrage. You can see the smoke mixed in with it as well. The artillery definitely found the range here. They're seeing the German vehicles, and they're putting fire down very, very close to them indeed. SDKFZ taking position at the front there. Infantry deploying from the back of the half-track armoured personnel carriers. Opening fire across the field there. Obviously, trying to knock out the white M3 wheeled scout car. They're trying to stop them from being able to direct the artillery fire onto their position. As you can see, coming in from the right of the battlefield now, local commanders called in some serious fire support. Local armour's in. Being led by the M63 Jackson tank destroyer, he's going to engage the German armoured vehicles. Supporting him, the M3 Stuart light tank. Joined by probably the most produced tank of the Second World War on the Allied side. That's the M4 Sherman. And in the same way the Germans have their half-track armoured personnel carriers, you can see now opening up with their Cal machine guns mounted on top of the hulls. Three half-track, the white M3 half-tracks, with their infantry support in the back. One of them also towing a small field gun. German vehicles manoeuvring on the battlefield, trying to engage the overwhelmingly superior Allied force coming up the field now. More of the M3 half-track being supported by a Dingo recce vehicle and an M8, that's the wheeled armoured vehicle, you can see taking position down there on the left-hand side of the battlefield. The armour is suppressing the fire from the German armoured vehicles so that the infantry in the back of the white M3s on both sides of the battlefield can roll forward in a pincer movement. The whole idea being to take both ends of the trench line at the same time. That is without doubt the most effective way of taking a defensive position. You take both ends at the same time and then you roll them up from right and left. Funnily enough, that is a tactic invented by the Zulus, of all people. It was known by them as the horns of the bull. You sent your flankers in from the left and right, and then your main force straight up the middle. People were so busy dealing with your flankers that they didn't actually see the main force working. That's precisely what's going on here. We've now got Allied forces on both sides of the battlefield advancing. German infantry deployed in the middle of the field, engaging them with small arms fire. Trench mortars in the main position, also opening fire. German armour being forced back by the sheer weight of fire from the Allied armour. M36 tank killer, particularly effective in this role. Going to try and deploy to launch his rockets towards the enemy. vehicle out in no uncertain terms. He's propped up alongside the Stuck 3. So the Stuck 3 can offer him fire support. Smoke occluding a lot of the battlefield. One of the things about a close infantry support operation such as this is the confusion that reigns on a battlefield like this, simply because you can't see, you're not quite sure who's where, you're not quite sure who's doing what. And this is where good command and good troop discipline absolutely comes into its own. You see the German trenchmen firing now, putting their own rounds up, trying to take out the Allied infantry as they're advancing forward. STKF sits in the middle of the field on the left-hand side as you're looking at it. Having been abandoned, the troops leaving those. Have been taken out by the N63, the M36 and the M3, the Jackson and the Stuart. And the British infantry advancing down the left-hand side of the battlefield. They're actually from the Leicestershire Regiment. The Leicestershire Regiment, a company of volunteer re-enactors. The Leicestershire Regiment, of course, did take part in the operation, not only the landings on D-Day, but the operations afterwards. So very much this was the sort of battle that they would have been involved in. You see the Allied vehicles still advancing. KF said smoking heavily as his destroyer boat been hit. They realised that was the main threat to their advance, and taking both of those vehicles out. And Fort Sherman joined the battle. You notice that the armoured cars and the tanks are advancing very, very slowly. The reason for that is so the infantry can advance behind them. They're actually taking cover behind the armoured vehicles to protect themselves from the massive amount of small arms fire coming from the German trenches now. Really start to mount.
as well. So they need to get into this big trench line and start rolling it up. The whole point is to make it. As you can see, some of the Allied troops utilizing the trenches against them. Full trenches having been overrun. Full of Allied troops firing back into the main German defensive position. Simultaneously, both into the main defensive trench. So I'm pretty sure the Americans are taking a lot of casualties now. In this kind of engagement, this is where the fighting normally is extremely desperate. Forward positions, and they're coming down towards the main trench line at either end. The movement has worked very much to their favour. They've got to take both ends at the same time. This is going to take one last big push. The infantrymen are going to have to come out of their trenches and run forward to take the last of the German positions. And I want you to imagine what this must have been like. They are running forward into defensive fire. And the Americans are in the right-hand end of the trench, or trying to. Leicester Regiment, down on the left-hand end. You see the Leicesters are in the left-hand end of the trench and they're starting to roll it up from that end. The Americans are working forward. Germans in the centre there, trapped in the crossfire. The ends of their positions have been taken and they realise very much the game is up. Allied infantry moving forward to take their surrender. And there are a lot of casualties out on the field, as you can see. Now the danger from German anti-tank weapons and mortars in the trenches has passed. The support vehicles moving forward. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, the last of the German forces surrendering. Just like to finish this part of our display with the words of Wellington, of all people, which is, there is nothing so terrible as a battle lost, as a battle won. Casualties on both sides, obviously, from the advancement. But I think that's important that you see this, because it gives you an idea of what people went through to free Europe from the tyranny of the Nazis. It was a bloody and oftentimes confusing affair. It is purely down to the discipline of the troops. So, ladies and gentlemen, as they come off the field, our commemorators. Germans, British and Americans all mixed in together, as it was on the battlefields of Normandy.